out there. My name is Caitt and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you my updated anxiety kit in honor of my first anxiety video being put up on YouTube 4 years ago. I still have the same little anxiety kit bag that I had back then. It's like a Vera Bradley makeup bag, I think. And I don't carry this around everywhere just because I do have like some bags that this won't fit in, or like if I were to put this in a bag then it would be the only thing that would fit in that bag. So sometimes I will like just take everything out of the anxiety kit and put it directly into the bag that I'm carrying around. And I'm gonna kind of go in order of how I listed things in my first anxiety kit video, and the first thing on that list is actually not in this bag, and I will tell you why in a second. The first item is lavender and peppermint oil. Now, I know that with essential oils, you're technically not supposed to put them directly onto your skin, which is what I do. So I found a roll-on essential oil. This is the lavender. And it's from the, I don't know if I want to say the brand because I don't like this. It's, the reason it's still in its box like this is because it leaks. And if I were to turn this on its side right now, it would be leaking all over the place. I have the peppermint oil, I still use it. This is also that same brand, but it is not the roll-on, and this one does not leak at all. It's perfect. And I use these the same way that I did the other ones. I just put a few drops onto my wrist and rub my wrist together. I have never had a reaction to essential oils on my skin. My skin has never reacted badly to it. But for the sake of this video, I am going to recommend that you get a roll-on or dilute it if you are going to put an essential oil on your skin. Lavender oil is good for calming, it's really good for anxiety, and peppermint helps kind of cool you down. Now I'm going to go into this bag, and the next thing that I mentioned in that video are cough drops. I use Luden's brand cough drops, and the cherry cough drops. I don't know if they have other flavors. They're really good, and they're not really for anxiety, but a lot of what I have in my kit too is kind of preventative, and you'll understand what I mean when I talk about them more. But basically, my anxiety is kind of partly from not being like prepared for something that might make me anxious because I'm not prepared to handle what is currently going on in my body. The next thing I mentioned in that video is gum. I usually don't have this much. I don't know if you could see how many pieces I pulled out of this bag, but I usually don't have that much. I use Trident's original flavor, which is like pretty sure just like mint flavor. If I'm feeling kind of anxious and like I need a piece of gum, or just to like prevent, like if I'm anxious, to have the gum like with me, because sometimes I can't carry around a bag with me and I just need to like have a piece in my pocket, and just in case I need it. Sometimes just having that piece of gum in my pocket makes me feel better because I know that gum also like settles your stomach. Not gum. mint flavor, like peppermint mint, settles your stomach. And the next thing on that list was throat lozenges. I don't use those anymore. I mentioned I use those for when my throat closed, but now my throat doesn't really close as often unless I'm anxious. The next thing on that list is actually headphones. And these are just headphones I got from Apple, and I have an iPhone 8, so I need the little connector. And I have a little shark on there. And I don't bring these everywhere with me. They usually aren't in my anxiety kit unless I feel like I need them. Like, I brought them back to my first day of in-person classes at my university. I'm mostly remote classes, but There are like sometimes when I do have to go in for an in-person class. Usually I'm fine with just taking my phone and like playing music, like my safe song I mentioned is "Woo" by Troye Sivan and Alex Hope. And I'm not bothered if other people hear it, but if it's on like the first or second setting, there's a good chance that they probably can't hear it if I'm holding it up right up to my ear. And everyone has to be at least 6 feet away from you now, so there's a really good chance that no one else is going to hear your music. Now the next thing on that list was a Sharpie. I don't bring a Sharpie with me everywhere now. I don't write on myself anymore. What I do now is I've seen in previous videos, I have a bunch of notes along my wall over here. So I will take like a little piece of paper, like a little like post-it note kind of thing, and I will rewrite one of those quotes on it, and I'll either stick it in my pocket or I'll put it in my bag, and if I ever need that reminder, then I can just take it out and have it with me. I remember I mentioned I used to do that in my agenda for school, and so that I would like always have an inspirational quote with me at all times, and I would like write a different quote in there for each week. Again, I don't always carry these around. More often than not, I don't. It's just when I feel like I need that extra like support, that extra motivation. And the next thing on that list was, the last thing on that list was Voltaren gel, which I used to have like a chest murmur, so that would kind of, and when you have anxiety, your heart rate goes up, so it was kind of, it was for that. It was prescription at the time, but I've seen commercials for it where it's over the counter. I think that's what it's called, but it's like where you could just walk into a drugstore and buy it. And now onto the additions that I have made to my anxiety kit. And the first addition that I made is actually taking some mint. They're peppermint mints, so they kind of do the same thing as the gum, except it's kind of just like, if I don't feel like I need the gum and I don't really feel like chewing the gum, I just kind of need that like cooling effect, and maybe like calm my stomach a little bit. The next thing in here is, I believe that I talked about these in a previous video, but I don't remember which one it is. I remember saying that I use ginger candy for nausea. Sometimes anxiety can make you nauseous. If I start to feel nauseous and I don't have what I need, I'm going to get more nauseous and more anxious, and it's just not going to be good. So I carry these ginger candies with me. I used to carry, what were they called? They were ginger gumdrops. I think that's what they're called, from the same company. The company's called the Ginger People or Gingins, and this is the chewy ginger candy. So I take these whenever I feel nauseous, or even as like a preventative, like before I leave the house, to make sure that I'm not feeling nauseous. The next thing in here is some Claritin. Now the last few things in here are like medications. And not anxiety medications, just, again, things that I think I need. So I basically take allergy medication every day, but there are some times when I won't take it. Again, my allergies are bad. I'm getting them checked out because they're year-round and they're, like, always strong symptoms. If you've noticed me, like, congested in past videos. So I'll always carry like a Claritin with me just in case I need it, if I forgot to take it that morning, if I feel my allergies start to act up while I'm out. The next thing in here, let's talk about this first. I've never used this before. It's a Dramamine anti-motion sickness medication. I guess I kind of brought it with me, again, because of the nausea. I used to have, I want to say, pretty bad nausea, kind of like nauseous every single day. So I got these because, I got these because I started to feel nauseous and lightheaded when I was in a room with a gas leak in it. So I was told by my doctor that these would help. And because they're for kind of like dizziness and lightheadedness and nausea. And the last thing, also not really an anxiety thing, these, I don't know if anyone's heard of these before. They're kind of like a new product. They're from Tylenol. And these are absolutely amazing if you can't swallow pills, like me, like myself. I can't swallow pills. They're very difficult for me. And I used to do like liquid medicine, but these are so much easier. It's like a little packet of powder. I don't know if you can hear that. That's everything that I carry in my anxiety kit now. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that this video gets as much views as my first anxiety kit video, just because this one's like updated and after I've had anxiety for 5 years. And my last one was after I had anxiety for 1 year, what I put together. So this one's from a much more experienced version of myself. And I hope that you enjoy, hope you take some tips away from this video. And remember to like and subscribe to be notified whenever I upload. And I will see you in 2 weeks with another new video. Bye. I want you.